Hey guys, it's Wolflaf, and welcome to a new series, which is about me remaking Mordhau for myself. And this is sort of the first episode where I'm going to be remaking the classes in this game, or my classes in this game. But I made a few rules for myself. One, first of all, any roleplay or meme classes, starting, I believe, at the monk. Everything below this, I am not remaking, or I am not going to be changing at all, because I do not want to have to make another 15 Lord of the Rings builds, because I love those movies. No, instead, I will be remaking everything from the Cancer Duels all the way to my preferred class in Invasion. Without further ado, let's begin the time lapse. Ooh. You know that feeling when you just deleted your entire Mordhau? Let me delete this. It's actually a crappy making of an orc. But you know that feeling when you deleted your entire Mordhau army? Well, you probably don't. So I'm going to start off from the top. I'm going to sort of begin remaking all these classes. And I will check back in a minute once it's all done. And I believe I have finally finished remaking all the classes that I really wanted to remake. So I'm here really now to show you guys all the classes that I remade. Now, if you might remember from way back when, even in the past few videos about Mortau, I had a classic class that I called the War Axe Chat. I remade that into War Axe Invasion class, which is a 2-3-1 with Bloodlust, Friendly. I thought it was really just an overall better version of my previous class. Now there's this Wyhander class. This is Wyhander Invasion class. It's a remake of my old Wyhander class. And it's a 3-3-2 with his Wyhander, Bandage, and a PV Shield. You might be wondering, why didn't you take Friendly? Woo! Because of the no team hit stop. Because of team hit stop, I really don't need it. I just downright don't need it. Now some of these classes, which I'll eventually get into, you might realize, hey, that segment wasn't in the video. And that's because I made these sort of on my own. This is recorded a day after the video. The original remaking of the classes was done. So there's this Maul Invasion class, though. If we get back into it, there's this Maul Invasion class, which is just 3-3-3. It's very tanky. Maul and a Pavi Shield. Very good class. Same with the Evening Star Invasion. It's just the same thing. It's literally the exact same class, but with Evening Star Invasion. There's an Executioner Sword, which... Oops, that was an accident. It's just a 3-3-3 with Executioner Sword, Bandage, and a PV Shield. Longsword, however, this is where it gets interesting. It's a Bloodlust build, so you might be saying, ooh, it's Longsword doesn't do enough damage. But no, you're wrong. Then that's all I have to say about that. Longsword doesn't have damage. It's pretty good for 1vx, so I took it with Bloodlust just because I have nowhere else really to put a Longsword build. Now this Falchion Invasion build, I love playing with the Falchion, and with the Cleaver as well. Falchion, 3-3-3, Falchion and Bandage with Bloodlust, that is insanely OP. Moving on to the next one, there's a Billhook. It also, this one has Bloodlust, and I believe the Billhook is also very underrated in my opinion. It's actually the same cost as a Longsword. I think I bought a Pavi Shield Longsword build, but I didn't feel like it with the Billhook because you would never really... Billhooks are pretty good for single target or really 1vx. If you're in a mosh pit of enemies, you're going to get screwed anyway, so there's no point in having a Pavi Shield to block projectiles. So I just thought it'd be a wasted points, and I should just put him into legs. Now there's this Greatsword build, sort of the same thing as that Executioner Sword. Very good build though. It's Greatsword's also a very good beginner weapon because of it's has really high damage and can be comboed on like the Executioner Sword. Next is the Poleaxe Invasion. If it will just open, this is a 3-3-3. Poleaxe Friendly. I just took Wrecker because I had nothing else to put those points into. This is a pretty good build in my opinion. Poleaxe is not as good as some of the other frontline weapons, but I believe it's still kind of better, good, really good for frontlines because not really invasion as much, but because of the way that its alt grip works, you can use it to build up the barricades, which makes it just passable for frontline. There's the Cleaver, which it's just the Falchion, but a little less damage, less points, so you could get an extra perk in, like Cat, which is, in my opinion, a really good perk. It's that or Fireproof. And there's this Bardiche build. Now, the Bardiche is probably one of my favorite weapons to use, just because of its target switch potential. It has all the benefits of the battle axe. It has all the damage of the battle axe with the range of a spear, with the range of a billhook, and that makes it really good in invasion. There's also this Maul, sort of lighter build, kind of kamikaze style. I decided to sacrifice no Pavi Shield
just because I don't feel like it was worth it. I feel like getting tier two with tier two chest was way more worth it because you get two shot by a lot less weapons, or by fewer weapons. Now there's the Pan Man, which is sort of a meme build, but it's kind of like my troll build that I used in the past, but not really as much of a meme, because Pan is still, the Pan is like one of the best weapons in the game, actually. It's very underrated, and you can use a lot of them if you get enough points. Now there's the Evening Star. We're getting into dual classes. This is an Evening Star dual class with a veteran, sorry, no, it's just, it basically just a very good class. It's 333 Evening Star stun, because I feel like if you get that extra hit off, or if you get the stun off, your opponent's just lost. There's the Maul, which is the same thing. I think I still took stun on this. Yes, I did. And it actually makes a lot more sense on this. There's nothing else you can really take with a Maul, because because you really need the stun, because you can't combo with the Maul, so it's pretty important. Now the Mace, also the Maul one hit kills in the head. The Mace duel is probably my favorite class for dueling, besides maybe Evening Star. But my Mace is favorite weapon to use because the feints, they have a very high feint window. I took two maces, by the way. It's a 333 or 332, two maces and a dagger. I just took the dagger because I had nothing else really to use it for, to use those points for. I also took Acrobat because mace and jump equals meme. Now there's the Rapier duels, which is it's a cheese build. Let's just be realistic here, guys. It's a cheese build with the buckler, 333 Acrobat. I don't use it as much. I use it when I'm losing because I don't want to lose, and I am a loser. But there's this Poleaxe duels, which is a pretty good weapon in duels. Its stabs are very good, and it's a very fast weapon, meaning you can use it for a lot. It has multiple purposes. Now there's the stun perk and the Acrobat perk. I decided to not take second wind because if you jump and underhand swing and faint with the Poleaxe, not too hard of a combo to do, by the way. If you do that, they most of the time will actually panic parry because they see you. They're like, oh, he's definitely gonna hit me. There's the Zweihänder, if it will open. It's the Zweihänder duels. Zweihänder is a very good weapon. It's pretty good in higher levels, but it definitely has its merits in lower levels because it's just, nobody really expects it as much, or to do as much as it does in lower levels. It's 333 with Zweihänder and no perks. There's this Warhammer duels. I chose Warhammer because I needed another cheese class and I was bored. Acrobat second win, pretty good for Warhammer, especially with the Acrobat, because you're going to be doing a few underhand swings, and if we all know the underhand swing meta, it's kind of disgusting, to be honest. Now there's the Battle Axe duels, sort of a different style for playing. Like, it, longsword is, and like axes sort of have their own unique qualities, but Battle Axe I feel like is really good right now because of the animation. It's pretty hard to figure out a lot of the time. Then there's the War Axe, sort of same thing as the Battle Axe. I think I got in one more perk. Wait, no, never mind. They're equal now, so I didn't. It's just the same thing, but with the War Axe. There's Executioner duels, sort of a clone of those earlier classes, like the Evening Star and the Maul, but with an Executioner sword. There's the Great Sword, which is probably one of the best duels weapons, just because of how versatile it is as a weapon. There's the Long Sword, which is incredibly underestimated in duels. I go against these people all the time and I'm like, how'd they beat me? And I realize, okay, I need to start doing this, because longsword, we all like know how fast it is and how English does not belong in my vocabulary, but basically we all know how fast it can be with its excels and its drags. It can be quite painful actually to go against. So longsword's overall a very good weapon. Billhook, very good for duels, just because of the stabbing damage. You can even use the alt grip to make the attacks. I think it does a little bit more damage. Pole Hammer. The only reason I really came up with the Pole Hammer duels class was, again, because I was bored. And because I feel like the Pole Hammer doesn't have a very good place in any sort of mode except for duels. Because unlike the Evening Star, it doesn't have the damage of the Evening Star. And it doesn't have the range of the spear. It's sort of that awkward in between, kind of like the Poleaxe, except the Poleaxe alt grip or alt grip can be very useful in duels. So yeah, Pole Hammer, just because I thought, you know, I might as well make a Pole Hammer class. Now, you might be noticing a few weapons are missing, like the S-Stock, but that's because I'm not a weirdo and I don't like playing with those weapons. I haven't made any archer classes yet, but that's not really in my agenda. I realize that these classes, they're generally for my playstyle. Like, I like using two-handed big weapons. In duels, obviously, I use the mace, but that's just because the mace is very good in duels. But otherwise, I think that this sort of just is a reflection of my playstyle with all these classes. But I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you all next time. Bye.